Excuse me, can I get a tardy slip? And why are you late?
There was this huge accident right outside my house. I could barely get around it. I think someone, like, died.
Well, don't you think you should have left earlier to account for that?
I wasn't aware there was a huge accident.
You kids are always on that smartphone, but you can't check the traffic?
I mean, even if I had known about it, I still would have been late. This was out of my control.
I can't relate to you kids nowadays. Back in the day, we used to show up to class 2 hours early with our books ready to learn.
So, can I get my tardy slip or what?
Yes, I'll type you up one right now, but let's talk about how we can improve this in the future.
Okay.
So when you wake up, you are not going to lay in bed playing solitaire, being lazy. You're going to get up, have a healthy breakfast, check your traffic app, and then leave an hour earlier.
Leave at 6 to be here by 8?
You need to be doing whatever it takes to get to school. Yes, hi, I just got the bill from when I stayed at your hotel, and I want to know why you charged me $4,000 in miscellaneous fees.
Sure, what was the name?
The name is Chanel C. Lewinsky. Let me see here. Okay, it looks like you took all of the items out of the room, so we did have to charge you for all of the items that you took.
I didn't take anything that wasn't mine. I paid for that room.
Well, according to what I have listed here, you took our curtain, sheets, comforter, shower curtain, pillow, television, alarm clock, Bible, telephone, minibar, hairdryer, robes, lampshades, and interestingly enough, part of the carpet?
Hold on, I did not call this number to be accused of being a theft, okay? I was a guest at your hotel, and I took what was rightfully mine.
Right, but ma'am, you can't steal our furniture. You can use the complimentary items, like the soap.
I travel all the time, and I've never been to a hotel that has this policy.
Right, well, you can bring everything back, or we can just charge it to your account.
If I bring it back, it's coming back smashed.
Okay, no problem. It sounds like you just want to charge everything to your account, so I'll go ahead and do that now.
So you're the theft.
Oh, honey, make sure you keep that window shade closed. I got astigmatism, and I'm afraid of heights, so,
Oh, when are we gonna get our meals?
There won't be a meal, but you're welcome to choose from any of our complimentary snacks.
No, because those people up there got their meals, and I want to know when I get mine. I want a hot sandwich.
The sandwiches are for our first-class flyers only.
I don't understand. I've been waiting all week for this. I've been fasting because I heard you have the best sandwiches. This is classist.
Like I said, complimentary snacks will be coming around shortly.
So what, like, crackers? I don't think so. I need to speak to your pilot now.
Oh, I'm afraid that won't be an option. Can I get you anything else?
So, just because I can't afford first class means I don't get the same privileges as first class, like a hot sandwich?
You're welcome to bring your own food.
No, I want that one. And while you're at it, get me a Cosmo and make it a double.
Let me see what I can do.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay, here's your food and your drink. Now, since you did order a first class meal, would you like me to charge the $200 to your account, or do you have a card?
Welcome to self-checkout. Please press begin to begin. $4.99. $26.99. Unexpected item in the bagging area. Please wait.
Is everything all right over here?
Piece of Yes, no, everything's fine over here.
Are you still there? Unexpected item in bagging error. Error. Error.
Yeah, I have a code. You're fine.
Oh my god, thank you so much.
$11.46. Unexpected item in bagging area.
What?
Do you want to pay in cash or card?
Card.
Error. Please swipe your card again.
Try again.
Insufficient funds. Please contact your bank as soon as possible.
I can afford this.
Goodbye.
I have money.
Fuck. Hi, ma'am. I saw you sitting over here and I really want to help you out, so I wanted to give you some money.
Oh, were you talking to me?
Yeah, I mean, I always feel so bad for people that are, like, in your situation, and I know anything helps, right? So, just don't buy any drugs. Just kidding.
I'm not homeless. I'm just waiting for the bus.
Well, I mean, you
must have something unfortunate going on.
Thank you.
I mean, anyone that has to ride the bus must not be too well off, so let me give you some money.
You know what? I'm not gonna take this weird pity guilt money that you're giving me, so no thank you.
Okay, let me be honest. My friends are actually over there recording all of this for my YouTube channel, so could you maybe just go along with the narrative?
Make it a 50 and you got yourself a deal.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Oh my gosh, who are you? Oh, sorry. Had a nightmare.
My god, I'm so sorry. I just wanted to let you know that you had dropped your phone.
Is everyone okay? I heard screaming.
Yes, I just had a dream that this plane went straight into a volcano.
I can assure you everything is just fine, so please lower your voice so we don't cause an unnecessary panic.
I have diagnosed nightmare syndrome. Do you think I can just control what goes on in my dreams?
No.
Okay, then try and control what comes out of your mouth.
Well, the least you could do is bring me a bag of peanuts for my troubles.
As we announced before departure, we're not serving any peanuts on this flight.
What?
Someone has a very severe allergy.
You know, that is the problem with corporate America, okay? Everybody has these convenient illnesses all of a sudden that just stop other people from being who they want to be.
I don't get paid enough for this shit.
Allergies. Nobody ever accommodates my nightmare syndrome. What about-
So, what are we gonna do with your hair today? I'm thinking that I want to go, like short short, like really, really short. Okay, so with the shape of your face, you may want to do something a little bit long.
If you could just do what I asked for, I'd appreciate that. Thank you.
All right. You're done. What do you think?
Well, that took long enough. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, it's horrible. It's horrible.
That's exactly what I was worried about. I'm so sorry.
Oh my god, this is not it. This is not what I asked for. I don't want this. Let's make it a little bit longer, like maybe down to here.
If you want me to make it longer, I'd have to put in extensions and that's gonna cost you-
I don't want extensions, I just want you to make this look longer.
There's just no way that-
Okay, did you even go to Cosmopolitan School? Because I think anybody off the street can do what I'm asking for. The girl back home can do anything I ever wanted. Why can't you?
I think I have a solution. We're just a little bit behind today, but your meal will be out shortly.
Of course.
You see, Amberjack, this is exactly why you want to make sure you're not slacking off and go to college.
Okay.
Yeah, that has nothing to do with-
Oh, no, you see, it's okay. This is a really good life lesson for my son. Can you tell him a little bit more about your life and how you wish you went to college and didn't end up here, all that?
Yeah, not that this is any of your business, but I'm actually in college. I'm working here so I can continue to put myself through college.
Okay, well, tell him about how your parents never loved you.
I'm not gonna say fake things.
Look, I'm just trying to set an example for my son so he knows what it looks like to be successful and what it looks like to slack off in school.
I don't think I'd consider someone that works two jobs and goes to school full-time to study biomedical engineering to be a slacker.
Engineer, honey, this is fast food.
Okay, and what's your career path?
I volunteer at the aquarium.
Oh, so you're the slacker in this scenario. Got it.
Hi, ma'am, we got a call about a suspected murder here.
Yeah, thanks for coming. Sorry, this was a really hard call for me to have to make. I never wanted to have to do this, but I have reason to believe that someone in my home is a dangerous criminal.
Okay, and can you provide some more details on what led you to believe this?
Well, last night, while I was doing the dishes, I just so happened to look out the window, and I saw them burying something in our backyard.
Okay.
She had been out all day with the girls in the neighborhood, getting into fights, going through people's yards, and then she came home and did this suspicious activity.
And where's the suspect right now?
Inside. She's still sleeping.
Can I come inside and ask her a few questions?
Yes, but let me warn you, she does not like strangers.
Ma'am, we're the police. We can handle anything.
This is her room. You can go in.
Please stand back.
God damn it, ma'am.
Hello?
Hello?
Yes, ma'am. How can I help you?
Why is the pool closed?
Because it's 11 o'clock at night.
Okay, I didn't ask you what time it was, did I? I know the time. Thanks. I have a date tonight, and I have two children upstairs, and I do not want them in my room when I get back. I want them down by the pool entertaining themselves.
Okay, well, we don't currently have a lifeguard on duty, and even if we did, we wouldn't allow children to be running around entertaining themselves by the pool unattended anyway.
Okay, well, I specifically booked this hotel because there's a pool.
I completely hear that, and the pool is open from 7 a.m. to 9 p.m.
I wonder if I should tell the news that this hotel doesn't accommodate parents.
I mean, you can. We literally have a daycare center in this hotel, so...
Well, I can tell that you're not a parent, because there's a certain mother code that you're not following in this situation.
You know what? You're right. I definitely cannot relate to the urge to want to leave my children by the pool at 11 o'clock at night by themselves while I go on a date instead of just get a babysitter.
How dare you?
Can I get a refill on this?
Yep.
Thank you.
Also, I just wanted to say that I know it's really late. I know you guys have been working really hard all day. I saw those rude customers you had earlier, so thank you so much for just being awesome. I'm sure people don't tell you that enough.
Yep, that's the food industry.
Oh, I know. I just think you guys deserve a little extra compensation after today. How many people are working tonight?
There's six of us total.
Okay, so here's $300. Just split it six ways.
Wait, are you joking? You're tipping everyone $50?
Oh my god, yeah, of course. You all deserve it.
Oh my god. Thank you so much.
No problem. Have a good night.
Yeah, you too.
Oh my god.
Hey, is everything still good up here?
Yeah, no, everything's fine. Are you ready to close?
You know, I think you'd be more successful here if you smiled more often.
Wow, do you really think so?
Yeah, show us that pretty smile.
Okay.
What the?
Is this what you mean?
That's freaky, bro.
Well, what's wrong? Didn't you say this is gonna get me a lot more money?
Dude, let's get out of here.
Well, where are you going? Don't you want more of this?
Oh, she's still coming. Get away from us, you freaky ass!
Hey, now where are you going? Don't you want my number?
Leave us alone. We don't deserve this.
Oh, what's wrong? Why aren't you smiling? Show me a smile.
Hi, ma'am. Did you have an appointment?
Yes, of course I have an appointment. It's not till 2. I am a little bit early. I was just hoping you might be able to squeeze me in sooner.
2 o'clock. Okay. It is currently 8 a.m. and we're actually very booked today, so I don't believe there's going to be any time to just squeeze you in before your appointment.
They did it for me last time.
Okay, and it is a new day, and on this day, we are not able to do that.
Whatever. I'm going to be waiting over there, and when a spot inevitably opens up, I'll be ready for it, so you better call my name first.
Oh, great. Okay, can't wait to deal with that all day. I can take who's next.
Hi, I have an appointment for 8 a.m.
Okay, perfect. I just need you to sign in right here, and then I can go ahead and get you back.
Beep beep! Rewind! I was here first.
Yes, and if this were a first-come, first-served scenario, I would congratulate you. I'd give you a high five if that's what you wanted. But it's not. It's by appointment. Your appointment's for 2, and it's 8 a.m.
Well, it's not my fault others haven't exposed themselves to time management.
And it's not my fault you have nothing better to do than hang out at the doctor's office.
I'll strangle you.
Sorry about that. Wait, what can I get started for you?
Wow, you guys are busy. That line was so long.
Yes, it sure is. What can I get you?
Is there anyone in the back that can help you? This is ridiculous.
No, ma'am, but if you let me know what you want, I can start getting you.
You know what I'm talking about, though? Like, look how many people. I was supposed to be at my appointment, like, 20 minutes ago.
So whenever you're ready to order, just...
Alright, I guess I want a turkey sandwich.
Great, and what kind of cheese?
What?
American. I'm American. American cheese.
Got it. Do you want that toasted?
Roast? A turkey sandwich? How long does that take?
No.
Okay, and what kind of toppings?
Why are you asking me all this? I don't know. Whatever comes on a sandwich.
Yes, but ma'am, this is a build-your-own sandwich shop, so I kind of need you to tell me what you want.
This is exactly why your line is so long.
Well, it helps if you can just tell me what you want.
I want the custom.
Right, so you need to customize it.
Oh, for the love of Christ. All right, let me call him. Bill, what do you want?
All right, I'm just going to need to see an ID, please.
Oh, that old thing? Okay, I got it right here. You'd think after all this experience buying alcohol, I'd remember to take it out. Here you go.
Thank you. You're 45?
Sure am.
Okay, and who was president the year you were born?
Barack Obama? George Bush?
No,
those were just jokes.
Franklin Roosevelt?
Dude, come on. I know you're not 45. This is a fake ID.
Oh, come on. Just because I don't know my history doesn't mean I'm not 45. I know about taxes and 1099s and car insurance.
Not a lot of 45-year-olds drink Four Locos.
Fine, can you just sell it to me this one time?
Get out. No, get out.
Ugh, fine.
Idiot.
Hello, woman I've never met. I'm 85.
Oh my gosh, no way. Hold on. Thank you for calling 911. What can I get started for you?
Oh, I'm sorry, that was for my old job.
What's your emergency?
Did you hear that?
A fryer?
Oh, a fire. Oh, goodness, that does sound like an emergency. Let me type that in.
Okay, so it's telling me to ask if everyone's out of the home.
Great, okay.
What do you mean you still have pets in the home?
2 dogs and 3 cats?
Well, that was incredibly irresponsible of you. Go back in and get them.
I don't see the relevance of there being a newborn. I'm talking about the other children in the home, aka the animals.
Well, I'm not going to send anybody to you. Maybe PETA or the Humane Society, because clearly you're irresponsible.
You started a fire, right?
All right, calm down. What's your address?
Oh, ma'am, please stop screaming. Ouch.
Now, I'm going to need you to go back into the home and save those animals.
Well, I'm the professional here. I'll walk you through it. No big deal. Hold your breath.
Hey, I need you to refold the men's shirts because I don't like how they look over there.
Oh, was there a reason that you can't do it at the moment?
Well, the manager's not here today, so I am very personally busy running the store. I wanted to take on that leadership role, so I'm kind of like your boss today.
Oh, okay. Well, I don't need someone micromanaging me while I work. I've been here a long time.
Well, I'm the manager today, so we're going to run the store how I want to.
And was this role assigned to you, or what made you think that you could just take on the role of the manager today?
I'm trying to be initiative.
Oh, okay. Well, can you do it somewhere else?
Sam, I really don't want to have to write you up for insubordination. Please cooperate.
Do you even have the power to do that?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Then do it.
Okay, maybe I will.
Any day now.
Or I'll write a letter to the manager.
Which is not you.
You're so annoying.
Hi, folks. Welcome in. Is it just the two of you tonight?
Whoa, sweetheart. That intro wasn't very welcoming.
Okay, so just the two of you?
Hold on. You haven't exactly sold me if I want to eat here yet.
Okay, well, if you're not sure if you're going to dine with us, do you mind stepping aside so I can help the person behind you?
You know, baby, I think you'd be a little bit more successful here if you smiled more often.
Thanks for the advice.
Come on, let's see the smile.
You know what? The attitude and the lack of care is a direct reflection on the ambiance of this restaurant, and you're single-handedly ruining it for me. I mean, to be honest with you, sir, if I've deterred you from coming back to this establishment to harass me or any of my other staff, I think I've done my job pretty well.
What did she just say to me?
I'm saying that I don't give a shit if you come back to this restaurant unless you want to eat and leave.
Well, you've got a bitch face.
Oh, that kind of gives me a reason to smile.
All right, everyone, this is a robbery. Prepare to get robbed.
You don't even have a weapon?
Actually,
shit, so I forgot my knife. Can we just forget about this?
Yeah, you're good. This happens all the time.
Really? That's horrible. Do you need, like, a security guard or anything?
You're not very intimidating.
That's fair. Could I maybe just be a cashier then? I'm clearly desperate.
I hear you. Just submit your resume and cover letter.
Wow, thank you so much. Could I use you as a reference?
Of course.
You know, I'm really happy I came in here this morning. I was having such a rough week, and then I even tripped walking in the store.
You did? I'm so sorry. I told the guys to pick that stuff up at the front, so this didn't happen.
Oh, no, seriously, I'm okay. It was probably just karma. Do you want me to deal with it?
No, you don't have to.
I'm so glad I made these choices today.
Yeah, and you know, you've shown real leadership skills, so I'm gonna put in a good word for you.
Great, so can I just take this?
Yeah, whatever.
Okay, so to return this item, I would just need the receipt or the tag that was on the shirt.
Honey, I don't have any of that stuff.
Gotcha. So I would need some sort of proof of purchase since we do have a 30-day return policy.
So what are you saying?
I'm saying that I can't give you your money back without a receipt.
Pardon me, but are you telling me you're just gonna keep my money?
Well, now it's our money.
You know, I should have known I couldn't trust you. As soon as I saw that blue hair and those big lashes and all those earrings, you're a crook.
We're the same.
You're done. I want a new cashier. I want someone else.
I'm sorry, ma'am. There's nothing I can do.
I want to speak to somebody else. I don't want you. No.
Okay, so let me know when you're done having a tantrum.
You're a witch. You're stealing from me. Everybody, this woman's stealing from me. Give me that. Everybody, listen up.
Give me our PA system. Customers, I'm so sorry about that. We have a Karen at the front. I thank you for your understanding.
And you know my name, so you're a witch and a stalker.
How did everything come out over here? Good?
Actually, I think you forgot to bring me the coleslaw that comes with my meal.
Coleslaw doesn't come with that meal, but I'd be more than happy to go grab you a side of it if you'd like.
No, darling, it definitely comes with it. I wouldn't have ordered it otherwise.
Aren't you supposed to know the menu?
Oh, look, a menu, and no coleslaw listed under your meal.
Let me see.
Well, it was definitely on here when I ordered it, so again, I'd be more than happy to go get you some. I'm just not gonna pay extra for it.
Okay, then I won't be bringing you a side of it then.
Are you gaslighting me and making me feel like I don't know what I ordered?
No, so here's the thing. Just because you have it in your mind that you want something doesn't mean you're entitled to it.
Oof, you hear the way she's talking to me? You're not getting any tip from us.
Okay, well in that case, I'll go ahead and drop off your bill now. This will be our last interaction, so you folks have a good night.
I'm a law student. I'm not paying 69 cents for coleslaw.
Then you don't get it.
Well, it's about time someone showed up here.
Oh, yeah, sorry, we don't actually open for another half hour.
Oh, it's okay, you're here, I'm here, just let me in.
Oh, I'm sorry, I can't let you in yet. I gotta open some things in there, like the register, and then I gotta...
Oh, well, you don't have to worry about me. I actually see what I want right there, so I'm just gonna grab it if you'll just excuse me.
No, ma'am, the store is closed. You may not enter, period.
I don't get it. You just get to decide who comes into your store?
No, not at all.
Well, then how come you can go in and I can't?
Because I own it. And very much like owning a home, you get to choose how it operates. Get it?
Well, then I guess you can let the police know why you're discriminating against me.
I mean, yeah, I'd be happy to let them know you tried to push your way into a store that's not open yet.
Hi, yes, I'm calling on behalf of civil rights.
Oh my god, put it on speaker, I gotta hear this.
That's a HIPAA violation.
You know, since I'm the owner, I just decided I'm not gonna open at all today, so good luck with that phone call.
Hi, you got the number 12 for the large soda, right?
Yes, I did. Thank you so much.
Here you go.
No problem.
I said thank you.
No problem.
Hi there, what can I get started for you today?
Remember me?
What?
I was the customer you just spoke with.
Oh, did I forget something?
As a matter of fact, yes. You forgot to tell me to have a nice day.
Have a nice day.
Too late. It's way too late now. I want to speak to a manager.
Okay, well, you're gonna have to come inside for that.
Another inconvenience? I don't think so. Put them on.
Yeah, I'm not gonna do that. The only way I'll help you through the drive-thru is if you order food.
Fine. Then I'll order a side of ketchup.
Okay, great.
Oh, and have a nice day.
Lawsuit.
Can I return here? I need to return this bird seed.
No problem. Is there something wrong with it?
Yeah, it doesn't work.
What do you mean it doesn't work?
I mean it doesn't work. I planted about 30 or 40 of these seeds in my yard and not one of them has grown any birds, so I think it's defective.
Wait. What?
I expect a full refund on this, and I want to know why this is even on your shelf.
Okay, let me just make sure I heard you correctly. So you're actually planting bird seed in your yard in attempt to grow birds.
Uh-huh, that's what seeds are for.
Let me just clarify here. I can see where the confusion is. So birdseed doesn't actually grow birds. It just feeds them. They're not plants, so. And I wasn't given this information at the time of checkout because, probably because nobody does that.
So what, I'm the idiot here?
No, I didn't say that.
Then how do birds even exist?
Eggs.
Hey, are you that girl whose mom just died?
Yeah.
What? Oh my god, that's so sad. Ugh, my friend told me about it and I was just like, wait, whose mom? And then I was like, oh wait, that girl from science? And then she was like, no. And then I was like, oh, and then I saw you and I was like, oh, I get it now. Wow.
Okay. Well, if you need anybody to talk to, I know exactly what you're going through.
Oh, you had someone close to you pass away?
Basically. Last year, I was dating this guy, and we really cared about each other. We spent every day together. We wanted to spend the rest of our lives together. And then his family put him in a new school, and I didn't get to see him anymore.
And then he died, or what?
Yeah, I mean, he didn't actually die, but not being able to see him every day like I used to and only being able to talk through DMs was just, like, it took a toll on me. I mean, it's just especially hard on me because I'm just, like, an empathic person, so I just, like, take in everyone's pain around me, so just, like, I know how you feel.
Welcome to McDonald's. What can I get you?
Is this the Wendy's?
No, ma'am. This is McDonald's.
So I'm gonna do 3 baked potatoes and-
No, ma'am. No, that's Wendy's. This is McDonald's. Again, look at the menu right in front of you.
Why is she giving me attitude? I don't know either. A junior cheeseburger deluxe, 2 chocolate frosties, and not one of those items are on our menu, which again is right in front of you.
Excuse me, what are you trying to say?
That you are at a McDonald's and you're requesting Wendy's food, which is right across the street, by the way.
Well, if it's right next door, why can't you just run along and get it?
Because Wendy's does not pay me.
Well, what do you think is more motivating in this scenario, a happy, content customer or a paycheck?
I mean, when you put it that way, money, money.
I'm gonna be parking my car right here until you fulfill my order.
Well, thank you for your honesty. I think I still have the number for that tow truck. Yep, here they are.
Hey, did you want me to clean up this room real fast?
No, you don't have to. I can do it.
That's okay.
Well, you hired me as your housekeeper, so I don't mind cleaning up.
True. I don't want you to do anything you don't want to do. So if you're not feeling it, I totally get it.
Okay, do you want me to make you any food?
I don't know. Are you hungry?
Yeah, but I mean...
You're hungry? Oh my god, we should go get something. Or I can make you something, whatever you want. Seriously, let me...
No, you hired me to help you, so let me help you.
Maybe if you wanted to just go get my wallet and order us food?
Okay, so you just want me to order takeout for you?
Well, not if you don't want to, because if you don't want to, I totally get it. But I know that you're hungry, and I feel really bad that you're hungry, so I want to feed you.
I am here to make you food. What do you want?
Oh my god, no, I didn't mean to make you mad. I'll find something. What if you just, like, crack an egg in my mouth, and we'll call it lunch?
All right, look right here, come on. All right, whoever's next, let's go.
Hello.
All right, sweetheart, you can go ahead and have a seat on that stool right there.
Okay.
Darling, we gotta get that hair out of your face. Oh.
Thank you.
So much better, you ready? All right, beautiful, I need you to look more towards the sky like you're looking for forgiveness. Okay, let's do a quirky head on a platter look like this.
This is kind of awkward.
You look fine. This is our parent preferred package. Keep that smile. Okay, now let's do a ponytail with our hand on our hip, hard fist into the chin, turn into the fist, and work in a smile. For this next one, I need you to hold the llama.
Can I just do like a normal picture?
No, your mom had to pay extra for those.
Oh, shiitakes. I forgot my wallet in the car. I'll be right back, okay?
I got a whole line of people waiting. I can't just hold your...
No, I'll be right back. Just 2 minutes. 2 minutes, everyone. Okay, wait.
No, ma'am.
Seriously? I don't have time to wait on this woman.
I know, I'm sorry. If she didn't have so many things, I would just cancel it. I mean,
who cares? She's the one that didn't have her stuff. We're all ready to go. Why should we have to wait on her?
Yeah, I don't see her coming. I'm just gonna cancel it.
Is this gonna be it for you? All right, $2.95.
Go ahead and swipe.
All right, have a good one. I'll take who's next.
Oh, excuse me. I am back. Sorry about that.
Okay, ma'am, let me just finish checking out these people and then I'll get with you, okay?
No. Remember, I was just here. I needed you to wait for me.
Yep, and I had a really busy line and I had to get all these people through, so if you want to get behind them.
It's not like I'm trying to skip the line, I just forgot my card.
Yes, but everyone else in line was prepared and you were not.
Back when this place first opened, this would never happen.
So what days and times are you available to work?
I can work anytime, Monday, Wednesday, and Fridays.
Oh, perfect. Okay, so I'm going to put you down for
Tuesdays at 8 and then Thursday.
Wait, no, sorry. I can't do Tuesdays and Thursdays, but I can do Monday, Wednesday, Friday.
Okay. Well, let me put you down for Friday and Saturday morning.
I work my other job on the weekends, so I can do Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays.
Well, I don't know what other days to put you down here for.
Okay, well, yeah, again, Monday, Wednesday, or Friday.
Can you work Wednesday?
Yes.
Okay, I got this figured out. All right. So I'm going to have you come in Wednesdays and then also Saturday evening, and then I'm going to need you to return again on Tuesday afternoon.
No, I can't do any of that.
We're having a hard time finding a common ground with you, so this isn't going to work.
Hey.
Hey. What are you doing?
Getting cereal.
That's all well and fine, but why are you putting the milk in first?
That's how you eat cereal.
You never told me that you're a milk first kind of person.
I guess it never came up.
Well, don't you think this is something you should have communicated with me before we got married?
Does it matter that much?
I'm sorry, I've just never known any civil being to put their milk in first. It's just unnatural. I don't know if I can live with that.
Sounds like a personal problem.
The proportions in that bowl are just so wrong.
Too much milk.
Exactly.
What do you want for lunch? What? I asked where I should stop for lunch.
Yeah, okay.
Take your time, I'll just wait.
Oh my god, do you know Juliana R?
No.
Yeah, you do. She's friends with that guy Cody and his girlfriend Kelsey from that one class.
Wait, Kelsey Jackson?
What? Not that girl. Ew, the one that always hangs out with Chris and Mason. You know. Wait, hold on.
So should I just pick where we're going or what are we doing?
What the fuck? Look at this picture. Why would she even post that, right? Like, ew. Aw, Katy Perry put out a new song. Yay! Wait, why'd you just text me? You could've just asked me in person. What the fuck?
I don't think I'm gonna make it tonight. I feel so sick. Ugh, no! Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm so sorry.
No, it's alright. I hope you feel better. Alright, bye.
Thank fucking God.
Imagine going out right now.